Most definitely, my brother. You see, this furniture that is here was manufactured by a company. Okay? These companies operate because there is a market. They operate because there is justification to make money. So if they close, what they simply do is they provide a gap in the market. And when they provide a gap in the market, somebody will come in and fill it. So a lot of the companies that were involved in the manufacture of furniture closed down. But then what has happened is you see what is occurring in Glenview.
We have seen fewer new investors coming in.
No. You have seen fewer new foreign investors. Because the reason you're looking at that, my brother, is because you don't have any confidence in your own people. Your own people have invested. I don't blame you. I got to invest. I'm one of my. And if we were to look at it from a numerical point of view, those are investors. Except that you don't want to recognize because he is black. You don't want to recognize him as an investor.
We will be able to fill in the big gaps.
We will be able to fill in the big gaps. And we need to be able to be clear here. And we have to be very, very clear here that we've got a trade deficit of $2.9 billion. Now, that in itself represents a market. So for companies, and really for investors or shareholders of companies that have got management that is irresponsible, they are going to lose out. Because ultimately, if a company fails to abide by the law, it is the responsibility of the management of that company that they're failing to abide by the law. And when a company ends up having to be closed down by failing to abide by the law, it also affects the management of that company. So in my view, I am confident that by issuing this statement, by being very, very clear about government's intention, we are enabling businesses to plan ahead.